Hello, in this video we are going to make a bullet animation using Blender and the Blender Quick Buttons button bar. First, of course, I press button 20 to connect the button bar with Blender. Then the next step is that I will add the floor to the rigid body by pressing button 2 on layer 1 with the left mouse button. Now deactivating the floor so it cannot be selected and will not be in our way. Next, I want to add the glass screen that we will later split, and our glass screen starts as a normal cube. This cube we want to resize a little bit to 25 meters, and we will drop it on the floor using the drop it add-on that I can really recommend. So it's not yet a perfect glass screen, so we need to change something, and what we change is this value here to 0.1, and now we have a glass screen. Maybe we can even make 0.2. It's a bit better so we can more easily see what's going on. So here is our glass screen. Next, we will choose the renderer. I take cycles, GPU, adaptive, denoising, and now I go to the material and choose two materials. This is not yet important, but it may be later important when we make the broken glass. So I make a new material and I choose a glass material that I already have, and I add another material here, and here I choose a more silver material, but which is more shining or looks a little bit different. Maybe dark glass or something else. So it should be two materials for later, for the glass breaking. Okay, so I have the two materials. Now I will move the plate a little bit. So now let me see, where's the 3D cursor? It should be here somewhere. Good. So we are there. So also add mesh and cone. Now I go here and I type plus 140. So where did it go? Yeah, it went here. So this is really far, but it's okay for now. So I need to make another change, and that is I need to rotate it by 90%. Theoretically I could just type here 90%, and now I want to see the cone, so I can go to layer 5 and I can press just the right button on button 2, view at selected, and then I see the cone a little bit larger, so it's now looking in the right way. So but this does not yet really look like a bullet, so let's make another bullet. And that is a cylinder. and we do just the same, plus 141, and rotation by 90 degree. 141 was too much. Let me move it manually. It's also easy possible. So I just move it here. And now we have these two. And now I wanna I want to connect them. So I want to have this one exactly with this one together. And for this, I want to show you a function that we have on layer 6. So first what I do is, I select this one and I select this one with the shift key on the keyboard press. So I have both selected. And I go to layer 6. And on layer 6 we have button 5, align at faces. So the next thing I do is I press enter, I press the tab key. So we go into the edit mode. So edit mode. And next I must select here the face select mode. That's important, face select. I deselect everything. And now I'm going to select one face on every of the object. So now you see I have selected these two faces. And now I just press button 5, align at actual faces. So that's all. Now I can leave the edit mode and you see both objects are stitched perfectly together. So now we can go to layer 4 back, and here we have on button 1 the function join selected. I will press that. So as you see, we have now one object from the two objects, and we just need to stretch it a bit to make it look more like a bullet. And let's see if we can add some modifier to make it look even more like a bullet. Let's start with bevel. Looks good. And so does it look like a bullet a little bit? Okay, more segments maybe. So, and why not also add another modifier? For example, wave is funny. What can we do with this? Achso, that's a bevel modifier here. Oh yeah, this looks funny. This is also funny. So, what else do we have? Not sure, this is a bullet. So, what do we have here? Yeah, could be a bullet. Okay. Now I go up here and I make apply all. So that's our final bullet and I make it into an own collection, new collection, bullet. So here is it. And we have the bullet, and the good thing is the way we did it, the bullet perfectly is directed to this point where we want to hit the glass screen. So we will make now the bullet to shoot there. And for this, I will add it to collection A, which is just one click to this button 16 on layer 4 with the right mouse button, also the node A. I press it, and this means we have now remembered this bullet in an internal storage, which is called storage A. We have A, B, and C. It's somehow like something that's selected, and you remember it. So next we need an empty. Here is an empty. Plain axis. And this one I make plus 5 meters outside. So this empty is now, you see it here, 5 meters outside from the point where the bullet will hit the screen. It's just a little bit outside. The reason for this is that at this place the bullets will leave the animation mode and go into the rigid body mode. So until here the bullets are driven from the animation, and from here they will fall like rigid bodies. So the next thing is I select this target object. That's it, this empty is just a target object. The bullet itself is in collection A, and therefore I can now click button 15 and frame slider is on 1. That's also okay, because this is when the bullets start flying. We can put it on 4. So I press button 15 and I give it 1.7, and I want 3 bullets. So we can experiment with this. We will just see what will happen. We are not satisfied, we will just do it again. Now let's see what will happen. I will press play. Well, that looks quite okay. So we have the 3 bullets, and they fly with good speed directly where they should hit the glass. So that's okay. So next we need to look at which frame the bullet will hit the glass. So we had frame somewhere here. Is it frame 25 or is it frame 26? Okay, let's say it's frame 26 when we hit the glass in frame 26. Okay, so this is just that we know it. It's frame 26. And now I go back, I select the glass, and we are on layer 4. And now I go to button 21 and I press the left mouse button and I tell him frame 1 to frame 26. This is the frame as long the glass should be okay, and later it will be destroyed. So 1 to 26 we have this glass. So next let me see if it worked fine. Sometimes it doesn't work. So it looks okay at the moment. Let me see something. So what did we do here? I just will tell you with this button 21, what does it do? This button will make the keyframes in a way that you still see the glass here. You still see it. You even see it here. But you only see it because we are in the viewport. In the render, as you can see here, the glass is disabled. So this means the glass is only visible in the render here. And once we come to the frame 30, this means when the glass got hit, here you see it, it immediately is invisible in the render. We will make one more thing here in 20, one more thing to get the glass out of the way, while normally it shouldn't matter, but we can also get it out of the way by going to layer 5. And we have here button set location rotation keyframe all selected. This is button 7. And I will now click this and set a location keyframe for the glass on frame 1. Now I will go to frame 26, no, first on frame 25, and here we'll also set a keyframe, a location rotation keyframe. And now watch, now on frame 26 I'm going to move this screen out of the way. And again set a location rotation keyframe, and the reason is that in this case it will not be a rigid body, it will not influence the animation because it's just out of the way. So this way we get the screen that is not broken out of the way. Now the next thing we need to do is we need to make the glass break. For this the glass must be selected, and we have the 3D cursor at the right position, which is important. This way. So we have the 3D cursor here, which is important. And we go to layer 4 and we just press button 23. And this will make the glass break. You see it here. We have now here a very nice glass break, and about this, if you don't like the glass break, it looks like this. As I see, it looks fine, but if you don't like it, you can just select it select objects and delete hierarchy. And the glass break is gone, so we can make another one. Just select the glass, press button 23 and get another glass break. Here is it. So in case you have first I select the glass break now. So in case you have here large parts of the glass that you think is too large, I want them a bit smaller. You can just select them and then press button 25. This makes a small glass break here. Here also can make a small glass break here. So that's nice. And now that I have selected originally this glass break, all the small glass breaks are also inside this collection, so we can select them all together, which is important for what we are going to do. So now I'm selecting the glass break. Let me just check something. Cube, it was frame 26 when we switched the screen. Also 26, yeah. In 26 we moved the other screen out of the way. So here 26, it's gone, and this means in 26 we will make the glass break visible. So I will go here and just I will open it that you can see it. I will make select objects. Now we have all the objects in the glass break collection selected. And now I'm on layer 4 I go to button 21 second. This means it's the right button. And I press 1 to 26. It's the same like we did before with the other glass. And I press OK. So this is now going to take a moment because it's a lot of glass breaks and each of them gets several keyframes. So we have the result. Now what you see here is that there are lots of keyframes being created. Disable in render, enable in rigid body, and the kinematic keyframe is also there. So this looks good. The thing that we have to do is, if you look here, you can see that the automatic mode did sometimes choose the wrong bounding box when adding it to the rigid body system, so we have to correct that. That's why I go to layer 1 here, and now we have in layer 1 button 11 mesh, and if I press the right button here, you see it's corrected. Now all the glass parts are meshes, so they have the right bounding box now, and that's all we need. Now we can bake the whole thing. I press button 9 on layer 1, and this didn't take much time. So now let's see what we have. Bullet comes, bam, glass breaks, and two bullets fall into the air. So that's the bullet animation. We did it quickly with the Blender quick buttons. So now I would like to render it. What can I do? I can just go to layer 4 again and press the button prepare video. We have 4K and HD. Because it takes too long, I will now press HD. And this means that all the settings for video output here, for example the file name in the same folder where the source file is, and the file format, and also all the settings here are set automatically. So it's just one button click again, like it should be, and we could just go on render animation. But we cannot yet render because we first should bring the camera in position. So for this I will just go into the explosion and select a bullet and go on layer 5, and then I have here active camera point at selection. Now I will switch to the camera that we can see how it looks. So this would look like this. We have another function. We have here camera, the button 2. If I press this, we will even get more near, but this is too near, so we don't really want this. Now if I zoom out, you see the camera is not locked. This means I want to change now the camera picture, so I need a locked camera. This means I press button 3, left mouse button, lock active camera. Don't worry about the error message. So now the camera is locked and we can move outward. And what happens now, there is a clipping in Blender and the clipping prevents us from seeing the scene. So for this we have button 4, switch clipping off. So I press button 4 and the clipping is off. And so we can also see the whole thing from outside. And now we can choose a nice perspective for the scene where we will set the camera. So, and it looks like this. So, and that's all. Now we can go and render the scene. So this was the simple part. I have an add, and this is about the original glass. Here, the glass. When you have pressed the button 21, the left side, and you set 1 to 26, then you should check that it looks like this, especially that that you get this result here. If you don't get this result, you can just do it again, press it, type 1, 2 and the end frame, enter, and you should have this result about the keyframes. And this is important for the result, otherwise the glass will not be visible in the render. So you need to have in the render here that it's visible. Okay. So now let's see if we can make this a little bit more far. Now look, we have here the bullet, this bullet, and this bullet, it will hit the floor in 67. So maybe we can also make this bullet to explode when it hits 67. So what we do is we just make a break of it, but we make it here in the scene. Now we must be careful that we don't intermix stuff, so I give this a name. This is the glass break glass, and so the next one will be the glass break bullet. So I select the bullet and I go on 23. Which takes a while, of course. So that was it. Now we have another glass break, and this is the glass break bullet 1. And if I select it, you see it's just here where the original bullet is. So now we are in frame 67. And this means I will go on button 21, press the right button, and we give here the 67 as parameter. And again, this will take a moment. So this is done. And this is the bullet 1 glass break here. Good. Okay, let's see how it works. So now the question is, if I bake it again, will the bullet land at the same place? Otherwise, we have to move the bullet 1 to some other place. So going to layer 1 and pressing button 9 for baking. That was it. Now let's see. Bam. Oh, that's strange. That's funny. Okay, this one, we must make this appear here at frame 61. Now at frame, yeah, at frame 68. And these ones at a glass break bullet. Select objects. Now, okay. They will be invisible in the render anyway, so that's not a problem. So, they are just at the wrong place now. So, need to glass break, select objects and move them to here. So, and then the other one will get invisible and this one will explode. Let's see. Now we have the problem that the original cube, this is going to fly away before the time. So I need to remove it from the dynamic list. So it's not dynamic. And rebake it. And let's see. And one explodes. Okay. So there's one more thing we can do. So if we look this bullet here, this bullet, now it hits the glass. So and this is cylinder one. So I first select this scene collection. Now I select the cylinder one and I say layer 4, button, this is 1 to 26, button 21, 1 to 26. Yeah. And now I give it a glass break, but I will do only a smaller glass break, otherwise it will take too long. So here is it. And this is the new glass break. And I'm watching that this is the active object. Now I say select objects. And this one, this is part 2, so I go to button 21, I press the right mouse button and I press OK. And now the keyframes are generated for these objects and then let's see what will happen. So that was it. Now the original the original bullet was cylinder 1, true. No, yeah, the original bullet was cylinder 1. Now cylinder 1 has already his keyframes. Okay, that's okay. Let's see. So, the glass break, which you can see here, looks like it's here, but is invisible in the rendering because of the, I will show you, because of the disable in rendering here. So it's only visible in the here in the viewport. So let's see how it looks. Oh, we didn't back it. Going to layer 1 and back it. And now. Oh. We have here someone who seems to be not dynamic. So this one. So enabled in rigid body, and he is not dynamic but animated. So I move here the animation away and make it rigid body. Back it again. And now it looks like this. Okay, we got it. The only thing we lost the bullet hole was floating on the floor before. Okay, now we can render it.